Hello everyone, this is Matt with the Maya Learning Channel, and after a long hiatus from making videos, I'm finally back. So, where exactly have I been? Well, I'm excited to announce that I've been working with a team of developers to put some brand new usability and learning-based features right into Maya. Features like a brand new home screen, or a new example character that you can learn from, use, and modify for free. And even new video game-inspired interactive tutorials to help newcomers learn the ropes or experts teach others by building their own. I'll be detailing some of these in my next few videos, but today I'd like to focus on another new feature, search. Now, you might be thinking that a simple search feature is kind of a weird one to focus on first, until you realize Maya has over 600 menus and hotkeys. Thinking about it that way, being able to not just find features, but activate and use them, all from one place, suddenly becomes extremely powerful. To show you what I mean, let's quickly build a crate. Something low poly that you might see in a mobile game, perhaps. To add some detail, I first want to triangulate this cube. But suppose I've forgotten where that option is. Instead of blindly going through these menus one by one, hoping to stumble across it, I can instead just click this search icon, and type in triangulate. And then I can just click to activate it. Notice now that if I go back to the search button, triangulate appears at the top of my search list, very handy for operations I want to do repeatedly. Now, suppose I want to bevel these edges, but I've forgotten the hotkey for bevel. No problem, I'll just go back to my search tool, this time using its Control F, you know, as in find, hotkey, to bring the search field up right next to my mouse cursor. Then I can just type in bevel. Notice I actually get two results here, but which one is right for me? Well, if I click these little information flyouts, I can see a description of each one, as well as instructions on how to use it. Since the second one mentions curves and isoparms, it looks like the first one is actually the one we want. Notice it even has a handy little reminder of the feature's hotkey for future reference. Then I can just do some quick extrusions. And apply some colors and textures. And finally search for automatic UV mapping to fix this texture warping. And there you go, a very quick techno box. Next, I think I want to add some handles, starting with a cylinder. I'll just resize it a bit, and add some divisions. Now I need to bend the ends of this, which I know I could do manually by moving these vertices on its ends. But just to see if there's an easier way, let me type in bend in here just to see what I get. Sure enough, I've actually got two options. When in doubt, try just typing what you're looking for in here, even if you don't know if it exists or not. Maya will show you the best results based on what you typed, even if the exact name of the feature doesn't match. In fact, in some cases, you can even type in features from other programs to get the synonymous feature in Maya to come up. Going by the descriptions, this one seems to be the one I want. Then I'll just arrange this to bend the way I want. And then delete its history to get rid of the deformer. Now, to get the other side of this, I'll just chop off the top and mirror it. Except, a standard mirror operation doesn't do what I want. Instead, let me delete this and then use the search result to get to the mirror command's options. Here I can change the axis position, axis, and direction to get the result I actually want. Then I can just move it into place and clone it to the other side. Finally, I'll run a union operation to fuse this all together into one object. Now, to give the scene a bit of life, I'll just open the content browser and import MayaBot, a new free rig included in Maya 2022.1. Now I just need a moment to come up with an amusing pose. Okay, so I think I've roughed out a pose that amuses me, if not MayaBot. Now I just need to go in and clean up the little details. In particular, I want to tweak the way these hands are wrapping around the handles I made earlier. Now, anyone with experience posing 3D characters has probably run into this issue before, where controls are so close together that it can be difficult to select the one you want. Thankfully, Search also comes with a handy select mode for finding objects in the scene. So if I just look up Ring 3, I can easily find and select my third ring finger control for my hand. And then just repeat for the pinky and thumb. In fact, I can even turn off the visibility of my controls entirely for better visibility of the final pose itself, yet still search for and move my finger controls. And this is just on a single character. Imagine using this to find specific objects in a densely populated environment or complex model. In addition to search and select modes, advanced users can also use this feature to find Python or MEL commands. You can quickly cycle through these different modes by repeatedly pressing Ctrl F. And like any good search feature these days, you can mark entries as favorites so they always appear at the top of the list, or use and create tags to filter the results. You can even search for tutorials and other documentation. So I highly encourage you to download Maya 2022.1 today, even the free trial if you're a new user, to try out this brand new workflow. It's already changing the way I use Maya every day,